linksaf naar Place du Château.
I'm just driving around in my little camper. I'm not on the big roads, but on the smaller roads. And with this camper, it's much easier and possible. But I come from the one chateau to the other chateau. It is really amazing. So I will show you. Look at that. It is really stunning. It's quite an extraordinary style for France chateaus. So it you me luck. Let's see. Let's go in. Yes, I'm really happy with this much smaller camper. Much easier to drive on the smaller roads. But okay, chateau. Let's see.
Bonjour.
Stunning. It's beautiful.
Yeah.
The start.
Here we go. Thank you.
In Gallo-Roman times, Jumelhak was an architectural estate belonging to a certain Camillus. Throughout history, it will suffer many attacks. In the 5th century, 472, the Visigoths gaining the north of Aquitaine, seized the fortified site named Camiliacum. In 508, the Franks rebuilt a stronghold that was plundered by the Saracens in 730-732 and destroyed by the Vikings in 846. This begins the history of the castle. 3 centuries later, influenced by the Crusades, a first masonry tower was built in 1152. The stronghold of Jumelhakum was then covered during the first Franco-English conflict. Left in ruins by Richard the Lionheart, it will be rebuilt before being attacked and destroyed by Philip August in the early 13th century. In 1258, a text mentioned that the lordship of Jumelhak is in the hands of 3 families, the Laporte, de Bruchard and the Tessiers. During the Hundred Years' War, the Guiseling besieged the fortress in 1370 and drove out the Engels troops of the Black Prince after 10 years of occupation. In 1579, Antoine Chapelle, a rich ironmaster, married Marguerite de Vars, heiress of part of Jumelhak. He then bought in June 1581 the second part of the estate. He paid homage to his overlord, the Count of Pericourt, Henry de Bourbon, Henry III of Navarre. The latter became King of France under the name of Henry IV. In gratitude for his financial help during the troubles of the League, he raised him to the rank of Count of Jumelhak, 1597. To mark his new status, Antoine Chapelle added the roof decorated with alarical ridge. After having restored the castle for 20 years, this transforming the room into a Renaissance residence. His grandson, François, was elevated to the rank of Marquis for his high military deeds. He began to restructure the castle in the taste of the 17th century. He transformed the first floor of the old castle into private apartments and reception room. the defense towers and the surrounding wall connecting them into residential, pavilion and certain walls. As for the wings, he reworked the pre-existing outbuildings of the ground floor into 17 wings after having raised them by one floor. At the French Revolution, the castle and the land will be sequestered, sized as obscene property. Antoine Pierre, Colonel Lieutenant of the Constitutional Guard of Louis XVI, having emigrated to England while leaving his father, fought Marquis de Jumillac under house arrest in Paris. The installation at the castle of the manipulation and the popular society and the popularity of the Jumillac will save the castle from destruction. In the early 19th century, Antoine Pierre, who became Marquis de Jumillac, devoted himself to sheep breeding and agriculture, creating a model farm. It having burned completely in 1808, he re-enlisted in the army under the orders of Napoleon I, continuing his career begun under Louis XVI. Married to the sister of the Duke de Richelieu, he became to her a parent of the latter in 1811. This is why he will sell his property in Péricourt, taking the castle out of the family for more than a century. On the death of the Duke, it is the son of Antoine Pierre who will inherit the title Duke of Richelieu and Fronsac, Peer of France. This is in 2.5 centuries the Jumillac have risen to the top of the French aristocracy. The property was then sold to the Count of Rochechouart, who settled there for 40 years until his death in 1858. After 4 years of joint ownership, it will pass to the Etienne family, great sugar industrialists of Nantes. Then by marriage to the Say family, Jean-Baptiste Say gratitude separate before the First World War from some 1400 hours of land still attached to the castle before putting the castle up for sale in 1915. Bought in 1917 by Mr. Bernstein, a merchant of Coutts, it became jointly in 1919 the property of two Jumillacois, who tried to save it from the state of abandonment in which it was. Three families lived there in the wings and the old castle to the point of raising a wall in the main country yard. The arcades of the curtain wall houses the shops of the village. The entrance to the castle houses the station of the Maître Gros railway. The reception room was the cycle merchant, and the shop was the wine and the spirits merchants. Return to the family. It was at the urgent request of Mr. George Bonnet, deputy of the district and several time minister until 1940, that Count Odette de Jumelac and his wife Mathilda du Bries bought the family castle in 1927. After many years of resumption of the shell, the castle will be open to visitors in 1964 and gradually restored to the point of welcoming today nearly 11,500 visitors a year. In the year 2000, after 6 years of restructuring, the terrace regained their appearance of French gardens and are now accessible to visitors. And since 2002, in the renovated left wing, the castle can accommodate receptions, seminars, concerts, theaters, and maybe a dîner d'ensemble. Today, the grandson, Henri de la Tour, Dupin Jumelhac, 11th Marquis du Noun, is the custodian and continues with self-denial and determination the work of his family by making you discover the history of this fairy tale castle.